Welcome to the Microsoft Mechanics. Coming up on the show, we'll explore the Azure Container Service, a new way to host and scale your applications in Azure. We'll take a look at the advantages of containers versus virtual machines, and we'll show you how to start using the Azure Container Service and how it scales dynamically. So I'm joined once again by the illustrious Corey Sanders from the Azure Compute Engineering team.
It is good to be back. I am surprised you keep having me back.
You and me both. So IT and developers have been using containers for a while now. What's with all these containers?
Yeah, thanks for air quoting them. It all starts with virtualization. Virtual machines virtualize the physical hardware. Containers are the next evolution. They allow you to virtualize the operating system. Thus, you can be much more agile and much more dense than virtual machines could be because they borrow from the underlying host operating system. Additionally, one of the really cool things with containers is that they are super portable. They can spin up an application environment in literally seconds, and they can do it on your dev box, or they can do it in the cloud or on servers that you're hosting on premises. All of this brought together brings huge advantages for both developers and IT pros.
You're talking a pretty big game here. Just how fast is this?
Let me show you. And with that simple command, I've spun up a container that is now hosting a website. And almost instantaneously, that website's up and running.
Impressive. Now, you just spun up a whole web server and a web server stack, and I couldn't even boot a VM in that fast.
Yes, and in the time that you just took to say that, I've spun up 20 more instances of that web server running on that same site.
Now, with this model, you can get all your apps and services provisioned and scaling in seconds. If I wanted to run this in Azure, what would I have to do to set up this infrastructure?
It's amazingly simple. We built the Azure Container Service to give you a one-click container orchestrator for your environment. You can spin this up almost immediately and have automatic failover, network controls, all sorts of capabilities that we set up for you automatically. Azure makes it really easy.
So how does all this work behind the scenes?
Well, there are a number of virtual machines running as part of the container service. These virtual machines are running orchestration software. We support Mesosphere DCOS or Docker Swarm. And as of today, I'm excited to say that we also support Kubernetes. Now, because everything is open source with the container service, we make sure your apps aren't locked in to what you're deploying in the cloud. You can deploy them anywhere. And once you've deployed the container orchestrator, you can then deploy your container-based apps using the instances underneath that orchestrator based upon the settings that you've chosen.
So how do we go about deploying this container service?
Let me show you how to deploy this. It's very easy. If you go into the Azure portal and hit New, and go down to the container section, there's a few options here. The one that you want to pick is the Azure Container Service. And from here, it's incredibly easy to get started. You go in, of course, put your username, and then you do need to supply an SSH public key, okay? And then you're gonna say, I'm gonna create new. Okay, I'll pick West US. And from there, I can pick the orchestrator. As I mentioned, we have two options. You can pick Mesosphere DCOS or Docker Swarm. In this case, let's say I'm going to pick Docker Swarm. And then from there, you can pick your agent count and your master count. And this allows you to say how much you're going to scale this, right? How big are you going to make this deployment? And I can pick, let's say, 3 and pick the DNS prefix here. And away I go.
So now you've got that service deployed. What does it actually look like to manage the service?
Yeah, so I've already got an app up and running just to show you how easy this is. And this app is running using Mesosphere DCOS, so the other orchestrator from the one I just showed. And here I've got in Marathon a set of containers deployed. And what this app is doing, it's a simulation app. And what it's basically doing is pulling from a queue a set of data, and it's doing this work on data. So let's say you were buying something from a website, and when you buy something, it goes into a queue. This is going to take that and do some work against it.
Okay.
Now what this needs to do is first I'm going to spin this up and get this started. And so as you can see quickly, I'll just scale this to 1, and that's going to start the app up. Okay, and so what the immediate thing it does is it spins up these consumers, and these consumers are taking this work from this queue and doing actions on it. Right now, there's no work on the queue. No one's hitting the site. And so in the meantime, I've got these other remainder containers that are doing analytics in the background. And this is something that people struggle with a lot. They've got a bunch of this capacity they need to use, and they want to be able to respond to traffic, but when the traffic isn't there, they want to be able to do work that's meaningful in the background.
Okay.
And so if I show you you this running here, you can see I've got here on this page, this is actually a visual view of the work that's happening on my site. And so you can see here I've got two containers that are dedicated to consuming data off the queue, mm-hmm. and I've got eight that are that remainder traffic. And here the red line is the work, and it's zero right now.
Right.
Okay, so now let's say it's a busy time. It's Thanksgiving, let's say, and I've got tons of people, let's say eight people hitting my website at once. So I've got these producers, and these are simulated people mm-hmm. hitting my website and putting work into my queue, and I'll make that into eight. And immediately, you can see the work is picking up on the site. So the red line's going up.
Oh, okay.
And so the work is going into my queue. And once it hits about 75, the system responds and says, whoa, we need to get more of these consumers taking that work off the queue. And you can see it went up from 2 to 3.
Yep.
And you can see immediately it responds. And this is one of the really powerful benefits of using containers for an app like this, is the containers respond almost immediately to the work and the changing work. And so you can see it's kind of going up, it's going down, and there you go. We actually produced another consumer, one less remainder, and the work is now actually on its way down, and the website is more responsive and reactive because of that. All of this happening with the very simple DCOS managing and orchestrating this across all of my infrastructure.
Mm-hmm. Now, great stuff. Now, you've been able to deploy a managed service that hosts containers simply and easily within that cloud infrastructure. It gives developers an easy endpoint to deploy their apps and services, and IT admins a simple infrastructure to go ahead and to use their environment.
Yeah, absolutely, Rick. And you can now take advantage of much more of your infrastructure by utilizing it in these sorts of ways.
So where's all this going?
Yeah, you saw me demonstrate the Azure Container Service for Linux environments. Now, Windows Server 2016 is launching with container support. Mm-hmm. We will also be adding that container support with Windows Server 2016 to the Azure Container Service, giving you a way to deploy both Windows and Linux apps all in the same environment and allow you to go modernize your existing apps very, very quickly.
Now, you know what the next question is. How are folks going to get started trying out this Azure Container Service?
You know, the best way is to do literally what I did here. Go to the portal, search for Azure Container Service under the Container section, and launch.
Thanks again, Corey. Really appreciate it. Awesome overview. And keep watching the Microsoft Mechanics for the latest in technology updates. Bye for now.